We're back now with a warning tonight about a popular food that many of us eat for breakfast. New research shows the number of medications that interact with grapefruit with potentially serious results is on the rise. Dr. Oluwaranti Akiyode is an associate professor at the Howard University College of Pharmacy. Thanks so much for joining us. We know that some of these reactions can be deadly. What is actually in grapefruit that causes a negative reaction with some medications?
Well, actually, there is a compound in grapefruit juice called furanocoumarins, and those compounds actually can inactivate the enzymes that tend to metabolize certain drugs. And so when individuals consume grapefruit juice, what happens is that those enzymes are not metabolizing the drugs. As a result, the drugs will actually accumulate in the body, causing the patients to experience toxicity from the drugs.
We've talked about what's in the grapefruit. Let's talk about some of the drugs that you're now starting to see have increasing reactions to this. What are some of the drugs or some of the medications that people need to be concerned about?
Well, some of the more commonly used drugs like the statin drugs, cholesterol medications, statins, Lipitor, Zocor, Mevacor are more commonly used that tend to cause that reaction. However, again, the key is not to be overly alarmed with the report that came out yesterday.
All right, so what sort of reactions can happen?
Well, reactions such as patients experiencing, specifically with the statins with grapefruit, they can have a myopathy, which is muscle injury, or it can also have a severe muscle injury whereby they will have what they call rhabdomyolysis, which is basically a breakdown of the muscle fibers, which can eventually lead to kidney damage.
What are the warning signs? Say you're on the statins and you eat grapefruit, but you're not aware of this, and you start, what would your body feel like? What are the warning signs that would give you the heads up that, hey, you need to call the doctor or do something about this?
Well, in the case of the statin, for example, if someone's experiencing muscle pain, muscle tenderness, those would be signs that at that point, you certainly should contact your physician.
All right, and if, once you contact your physician, what should you do if you're one of the people who take some of the medications that we now know are interacting and have possible dangerous reactions with grapefruit? Should you stop taking that medication, or should you go and consult your physician?
It is absolutely important that you really contact your physicians before you stop taking the medication, because it's really important to realize that for example, in the case of statins, not every statin actually can interact with the grapefruit juice. There are some other non-interacting alternatives that can be utilized as well.
When you say alternatives, what do you mean?
For example, within the statin class, there's other medications like the pravastatin, Pravacol, rosuvastatin. They actually would not cause the interaction as much. So therefore, if you the patient actually needs to be on a statin, the doctors can give an alternative that does not interact with grapefruit.
And so bottom line, if you know you're taking one of these medications that could interact with grapefruit or grapefruit juice, should you just keep grapefruits out of your diet?
Well, the key about it is to make sure that you know for sure from your physician or your pharmacist that there is interaction. Again, I really don't want us to get overly alarmed with the report that came out yesterday, because indeed there is an increase in number of drugs that do interact with grapefruit, but not every single drug. The key is to make sure that you always ask your doctor or your pharmacist, is there interaction? Because the interaction varies. With some medications, you may just need to reduce the amount of grapefruit juice, whereas with some medications, you really should just not take grapefruit at all.
All right. Certainly good advice, and most of all, talk to your doctor. Dr. Oluwaranti Akiyode, thanks so much.